Welcome to yet another, our second, live stream from the VJ.com studios high atop the Museum of Modern Art in New York City. As you can see, we changed studios from last week. Last week we were in our living room. This week we've actually moved over to our office with this nice white background behind us. So if you like the studio, write in and let us know. If you want to go back to the living room, tell us that too, because we'll do what you want to do. Anyway, today's topic to talk about, and please be free to send in your questions on this, or in fact any other topic that you want answers to, because that's what we're here for, is how to start your own TV channel. This may seem a crazy thing to say. Certainly, 10 years ago or 20 years ago, if you said you want to start your own TV channel, that would have been crazy. I actually have worked on starting several TV channels, including Current TV and Oxygen, and I can tell you that the kickoff price for Oxygen was about, well, it was in the hundreds of millions of dollars, and that wasn't an unreasonable number, because that's what it cost to get in the television business in those days. Television, when it was invented in 1924 by John Logie Baird for our British friends, or by Vladimir Zworykin in 1939 in the United States, didn't come with an instruction manual. There was no book that said, here is how the medium is supposed to work. The medium developed the way it did because of the technology, and the technology of making television. And when I say television, it's a very broad sense word. It's video, it's online streaming, it's YouTube, it's all the same thing. Let's not just think of television in that box in the corner. When television was first invented or released in the 1930s, actually post-war, 1945, It formed the architecture that it did because of the technology required to make it. It was incredibly expensive. Cameras were these big heavy things. You needed studios, you needed massive lights, you needed tons of people to do it, and most significantly, you had to push the signal through the air. That's why they used to say on the air. That, in retrospect, was a crazy way to make television. That's why people had those antennas on top of their houses. The electromagnetic spectrum defined the number of channels that you could have in any one given area, because broadcasting required an enormous amount of analog wavelength in order to get the signal from the broadcast tower, which cost hundreds of millions of dollars anyway, into everybody's individual homes. So from the first 20 or 30 years of television, there were only five channels, seven channels. In Britain, there was only one channel. It was the BBC, and then ITV came along, there was a second channel. Because it was complicated and expensive, the number of channels were limited. Because the number of channels were limited, because it was so difficult to get in, this notion grew up that broadcasters like BBC or CNN or people like that were somehow special people who had a special right to do it. In fact, in the United States, licenses were given for free, which is hard to believe when you think of the value of the thing, to different spectrum on the wavelength, to different networks. So ABC got a license, CBS got a license, NBC, they got them for free, even though in theory the airwaves belong to the people. And the upshot was that they got them, and these became machines to print money. The upshot was that in exchange for that, they were supposed to present the news as a public service. Well, of course, the news became profitable. The whole thing got messed up. The next piece of technology that came along was cable. And we went from two channels or three channels or five channels to 50 or 70 or 100 to 500 or 1,000 or almost 2,000, which we have around here. I mean, who the hell looks at most of them anyway? But suddenly, the ability for more and more people to get their signal into people's homes was expanded because of the technology. So now you've got the birth of things like Discovery, which is worth, I don't know, $100 billion, and Scripps and HGTV and all these cable channels that feed off the same mentality of we make it, you watch it, and we append ads to it. As the internet became video adept, and that's where we are now, and it's day one of the video adaptability, it's still very rough. I mean, I'm webcasting to you now, which would have required hundreds of thousands of dollars to do only a decade ago. Satellite connections and cameras and lights and downloads and downlinks and all kinds of crap like that. Now all I have to do is sit here in the office, turn on the laptop, and bang, I'm in front of you. Well, of course, it's limited because it's only members of VJ.com, but it's also, in theory, if you follow what I do on Facebook, you can do this to, you know, 6 billion people who are online at any given time. So the leap that went from broadcast to cable that opened the opportunity for hundreds or thousands of cable channels, not only in the United States but around the world, that leap has now come again between cable and webcasting, which is what we're talking about. And now anyone, which is quite a remarkable achievement, anyone can have their own cable webcast channel. I hope you enjoyed that, and if you want to learn more and see more, come and see us at thevj.com.